Hello and welcome to my reaction to the final episode of my summer game Miteru. So episode 13 of season 4, the end of the journey. Yeah, I'm very sad, like genuinely sad. I enjoyed this. I was expecting to really like it, but I liked it even more, you know. And so yeah, the fact that it's ending and it's not gonna be a proper ending because it's not the full adaptation of the novel. At the very least, it's gonna, I guess, close the story thread that I most want to see close. Like, I'm pretty sure Yumi and Toko will be sister. So I will be very happy with that. And in truth, you could say that there's not, once this is resolved in this episode, there's not too much other stuff that are really going on right now in terms of story thread to close. So yeah, it could be a good way to end it, yeah. But still, if you ask me, I would wish it was a complete adaptation. That's what I would say about anything I watch. Complete adaptation is the ultimate thing. Yeah, I guess, as always, in this video, after my reaction to the episode, I'll do my review of everything, who's my favorite, all that shit. I also try to look up if there is a translation for the novel, or someone made a summary of what happened after the show, up to the end. I'd like to know that. But yeah, for now, the final episode. Toko was running towards Yumi, and Sachiko was going towards Yumi, so it made me think that maybe Yumi is hiding the card on herself. That seems a bit weird, but at the same time, maybe. Or under a chair, something like that. Yeah, let's just get into this. I just want to watch it. Episode 13 of season 4, the end of the journey. Let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. I've also already picked out some of the next shoujo Yuri show I want to react to. I'll tell you what it is. After one, obviously. Oh, it's been a while. Last time the opening. I really don't want it to end seriously. Sachiko got up, going towards Yumi. Was I right? Probably. She was sitting on it. Move your ass. No, okay. Damn. Not what I was expecting. It's right there. Les retrouve elle. Okay, they fucked up the French there. Okay, they meant les retrouvailles. Okay. But they fucked it up anyway. So no one's getting it. Yes. Nice. That's kind of random. Went well, I would say. Not the really. I was going to say they have a lot to talk about now. I mean, not that she wants it, there's no reason to wait, but first talk it out at least, clear everything up, that's the very important part. don't think that's the moment. It will be either during the date or once again in front of the statue of Maya-sama. She really changed pretty quick. You know, this is definitely my best ship, my favorite ship. I love those two so much together. Best ship for me. Okay, we finally get a clear explanation. Guess, yeah. Yeah. But that's good parents to tell you that. Okay. Quite like the music right now. Of course. Of course. Okay. That's a pretty big place. That's not what I was expecting. Dude, okay. So those were your will burnt, okay. Damn, you survived. That's crazy. I was going to say a girl. Yeah, no, she needs to tell it out. Real mom. Okay. That might also be why she took you in. knows the secret. I'd like to say this is perfect for a case, but I don't think it will happen. Not in this show. The legendary shoulder pillow. Yeah, it has to be in front of the statue. Yeah. Damn, I was. Yeah, fuck, it's the end of the episode. I was worried to look at the timeline because I knew we were close, but fuck. Fuck. I wanted to see the actual making. I guess we saw a bit, but fuck, and that's it. This is really like the biggest downside to the medium of an anime. Incomplete story. Man, I don't know what to say. That was great, but at the same time, I wanted a bit more. I wanted an actual scene for the giving of the rosary and maybe seeing a bit afterward of them being together and seeing how they act as sister now. Fuck. It's really annoying. I mean, I've watched so many anime by now, but still, I never get over it. When you really like a show and it's not a complete story, it's really on. And yeah, obviously, I mean, this season aired like 11 years ago, 2009, so it's always possible. I always say never say never, but we can't really expect another season. Okay, that's it. Yeah, we can't. I mean, the novel ended 8 years ago, the final season ended 11 years ago. I'd be surprised if we ever get more. And that was a great final episode. We got everything resolved. We know everything about Toko and what was going on. It was maybe a bit quick, I feel like it could have been dragged on a bit more to hit every point of the issue that were brought up to now. But still, this was satisfying to an extent. As I said, I still wish there was at least one or two more episodes. But yeah, I guess that was satisfying. So, before anything, I guess the rating for this season, I gave the three first season 8, and I think I will give this one 9. As I said, the Yumi and Toko relationship became my favorite thing of the show. Toko became my favorite character, so I feel like it's only fair. My rating represents that. So yeah, this season is a 9. So if you watch all my reaction, you know season 1 and season 2, my favorite character was Sei. And then when Toko showed up, I immediately was thinking she would become my favorite if she had enough screen time. And she definitely did in this final season, and she did become my favorite. I really like her arc, that was fucking great. I remember at the beginning of the show when I was saying that Yumi was just... she was just a basic boring character, you know, that we've seen before. But it's true, but it's not true. I ended up liking Yumi way more as the series progressed, especially in this final season. She changed quite a bit, and that was pretty cool. Oh yeah, one thing I wanted to address is how subdued of a Yuli / Shoujo Ai series this is. You know, I was thinking yesterday, outside of reaction obviously, I was thinking about how it's, you know, some people could watch this show, some people who have never really been into or even know what a Yuri or Shoujo Ai series is, they could watch this show and definitely not really get the romance undertone of it all. This show could be seen just as girls' friendship, you know? Not romance, not Shoujo Ai / Yuri. I mean, I feel like it's so subdued compared to most manga or anime Shoujo Ai and Yuri that I've seen. Like, it could really, the argument could really be made that it's not that, it's just a friendship show, you know what I mean? And yeah, I wouldn't be fighting someone who would think that, you know? I would be like, maybe, I'm not entirely sure, because yeah, in truth, it could be seen that way, is what I feel. Personally, with my inclination toward being a big Yuri and Shoujo Ai fan, obviously I want to see it as, yeah, this is what it is. But yeah, there was never really any kiss or anything of that kind, which I don't know, I think I kind of like. It really makes this show stand out among the few Shoujo Ai Yuri anime and among the many manga. What else? I liked most of the character. Yeah, I mean, I don't really know what to say individually for each of them, but I really liked most of the character. I don't think there was any character I disliked. Maybe Kashiwagi at the beginning, but he turned around at some point. He's actually kind of a cool dude. Yeah, I'm trying to think what else to say, but that was just a good journey. I'm happy I reacted to it. I'm definitely not expecting many people to watch this reaction. I mean, this is not that well-known of a show, but I don't regret it. I guess I could tell you right now the three next Yuri Shoujo Ai show that I've got on my computer that I consider reacting to next. I'm not saying when. I'm not promising this show, obviously, you know how I operate. If I don't enjoy them, I'm not gonna post my reaction. So, one is Simon, one is Aoi Anna, and one is Candy Boy. So yeah, I know there's many more, like Maria Olic and many more shows. But that's the three that I chose for now, you know, maybe next when I feel like watching, reacting to another Shoujo Ai show. It might be just an extra act 2 or later. Who knows? What don't to say? But yeah, obviously don't hesitate to recommend me more show, be it shoujo, yuri show, or anything of the sort. So now that's all out of the way, I wanted to see if I could find some kind of summary for what happened in the novel. Let's see. I found a blog post or something. I'm seeing someone blog post from 2012. I'm reading a part as always. I thought the anime wouldn't differ a lot from the original novel. Oh boy, was I wrong. The anime did pretty much stay true to the original storyline from the novel, but there are bits that were omitted from the anime. It didn't affect the storyline as a whole, but it doesn't feel right, you know. The problem with the anime is they ended thing in at the wrong time. They should've gone and make season 5 because there are a couple of novels left, damn it. Yeah, okay. The most shocking info that I've gotten from reading the novel is, spoiler alert, something about Shimako. Okay, no. The blog end pretty soon, so I don't think it's a summary. Yeah, okay, I'm not gonna do my research on video because I don't know if I'll find anything. I guess, yeah, I will do my research, and if I've actually found a summary of the novel, I'll read it and then add a section to the end of this video. So for now, that's it. If I find any summary or something and I can read to the end of the story, I'll do like a review or something. But yeah, for now, that's it for Miteru. If any of you actually followed my reaction from the beginning to this series, thank you. Really enjoyed it. Definitely don't regret that one. But I mean, yeah, that's an abuse. And yeah, feel bad to let it go, but that's it. That's the end of my summer. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one, whatever that is. See you.